and always delivering a message from God. Yet I want to meet my brother Dwayne Helborn. Guys, so that you want to meet sa niya ako is
kasa. Okay, thank you.
Yes, thank you so much. Only one microphone?
I am myself after my desk.
Okay, so okay, I'll preach and you can just talk very loud.
Okay. Yes. I think they're fixing the other line.
Okay. You know, yesterday afternoon I was walking around the Glory Farm. And as I was walking around, I was praying. And the Holy Spirit gave me a word. And last night, late last night, and all this morning, I've been praying this word. And the word is about casting your cares upon the Lord. Last night and this morning, I can feel in my spirit. That there are many cares and burdens we can carry in our hearts.
And
these cares and burdens can become oppressive to our spiritual life. When we have cares and burdens that we hold on to in our hearts,
get nata rin tipa kasapulan nata rin tipa kadalang senang nga kasla idudulin tayo manipot ko ang gantipos sa tayo.
Our spiritual life becomes oppressed.
Get ata itin absat ka rin ang spiritual na panabiyak tayo kahit kasla may tal-tal mo.
It becomes difficult for us to feel the presence of God.
Get ata manumanisan naging nga pakasapulan pakadalang senang iso na rin tiwagas nga mamagdaksin di panagrib na tayo di presensya niya po Diyos.
It becomes difficult for us to have faith.
Kaya nakarigrigat nga mapatao di makunkunan na pamati.
When our cares and our burdens are being held within our hearts.
Kaya nating ipakasapulan, kaya pagkadadagsinan, iso dati kaslamang tentengel, kaya itipos sa tayo.
It becomes difficult for us to pray and release the anointing.
Kaya nating itiyempo na, nating ipanawin kakunana, nga nakarigrigat nga karara, nakarigrigat mga marik na di pamulot, ay tinapsat tiyapo.
It becomes difficult for us to have joy and to be happy.
Kaya nakarigrigat ba't nga umisim ka, nakarigrigat nga marik na mdirago, ay tinapsat.
Even this morning as I was praying, the Lord was showing me that there are burdens that I have been carrying in my heart. And I was not even fully aware that I was holding on to these things. See, we need the Holy Spirit. We need the Holy Spirit to shine His light upon our
hearts.
And to show us the true condition of our soul. So this morning when I was praying, I can feel that there are burdens I've been carrying in my soul. You know, I've been carrying burdens about financial issues. I've been carrying burdens about my children. I've been holding on to worries about my future. And the Lord showed me this morning that there is stress inside my soul. There's emotional pain that I have been carrying. Because I have been carrying my burden.
ordinance.
I mean, bukod ko nga awitan na dili ang padulang sinat ko nga.
You know, the Bible tells us in 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 7.
I mean, kung ano di mo na nga Pedro, kapitulo 5, versikulo 7, kung ano di Jacob sa...
Cast your burdens unto the Lord.
Nga kung ano na itakling niyo ti Apo, dahil ti Amin nga pakasapulan niyo.
For he cares for you.
I mean, ni Apo Diyos kitipagpakay ka nga.
You see, this is more than just a nice verse of scripture.
Kaya kung ano na nalablabis pa ay nagiting abalbalikas ka absat ka kasla ibagata yung napipintas ka abalbalikas ka eskratura.
There is spiritual truth in this verse of scripture.
Kaya nakita ka na ito na absat na ito na eskratura at napintas ka kahit na nasawin.
And if we can learn to practice this spiritual truth.
Kaya kahit kaya tumasosura tayo ngayon nga naatanan na ito yung spiritual na tinapunto ko na nakabsat.
It will set your soul free.
Get ko na naatan to mawaya-waya na tayo kararuam. Amen.
It will deliver you from spiritual oppression.
Get atan to ay kinapsat ka waya-waya na kakaraiti panakaising galot mo karaiti na spiritual na panakaibababang kabsat.
If you can take the truth from this verse of scripture.
Get na alamin din na spiritual na tinapunto mo dito na eskratura pa na.
Cast your cares upon the Lord.
Makunana tayo ngayon takbin niyo amin, kinapis ka rin tayo amin na pakatanagan niyo, panana.
You can be delivered from demonic oppression.
Kaya kung ano, at ang tumamawayawayan ka ka iti, panakabalbalot mo iti demonyo, panana.
A new level of power of the anointing of the Holy Spirit.
Kaya matan ka ito ay tinapsat ni Baro, nga pamulot ti Apo.
Can be released in your life.
Nga at ang tumamayapan ditabiyak mo.
If you cast your cares upon the Lord, if you take all of the issues that you are carrying as burdens in your heart, if you learn to release them with faith and the anointing toward God, God will pick up those burdens. And he will bless the circumstances of your life.
Hindi ay pagpalinan na itong abendisyon na hindi mapaspasamak na hindi panagbiag mo ka sa amin.
You know, God will only bless what you give to Him.
Amoy ka sa kunana, ni Apo Diyos, bendisyon na lang, digay mabalin mo nga itad ka niya.
If you allow your soul to be filled with burdens and cares,
na malupusam na kikararuam, dahita kararuam, kat tipon-punuan na katadaksan lang, wala na hindi pakadaragan.
If you allow your emotions to be filled with worries and fears, if you allow your thinking to be filled with stress and worries and anxiety,
get no day pan panunot mo kat punpunuin dagiti saan ko mga pan panunot ka makayaya itirap sa dagiti mambanlog dagiti pan panunot mo,
then you are holding on to the cares by yourself.
Get ko na na itirap sa siksikala iti manol awit deta siksikala awan pulos ka tuwan.
And if you are holding them to yourself,
get no awit awit mula na nakapukudan ko na na,
then God cannot bless them.
May ako yung saan na itong mabendisyon.
If you want God to bless the circumstances of your life,
no kaya mo na bless yet bendisyon na dagiti circumstances kung tansya mapaspasamak na biyag mo.
You have to work with the Holy Spirit that is inside your spirit.
Magpipagtrabaho ka ay tinapsat ni Espiritu Santo nagbibiyag ni sa puso.
You have to work with the Word of God.
At ang magpipagtrabaho ka ay sa uti Apo.
And you have to lift those cares and burdens out of your soul.
And get the idea up sa tatang ko ma kay katarum amin amin nga pagkatak sina manipot ta kararuam.
And you have to hand them up to God.
Get the tatang alam na kita pagkatak sina kay iyawat mo kanya ko Dios.
Yesterday and today as I was praying.
Get ko na na manipot ti alman kay ore pa tata.
I was walking around the glory farm.
Get the tatang na pagpag na DJ ko na na di pagiyan ng takapsar.
And I was praying, God, pick up my burdens.
Get kung parang nakinyapo yung sapo alam na kiniyong pratulak sa na.
Holy Spirit, lift the burdens out of my heart.
Spirit Santo, at ang nga ikatulim, at ang alam na kito yung mapagatulak sa na.
And sometimes I was walking around praying in tongues.
Get kaya yung mga numaminsan at ang pagpag na nagsasawa ng karaisabali ng pagsasawa.
And I'm asking the Lord to show me what are the burdens in my heart that I have been carrying.
Get kung parang nakawa na kinyapo yung sapo, at ang kiting mapagatulak sa na, kanya na kiting awit-awit ko apo ko na.
And the Lord was showing me that there is stress.
At dahil di panakabanog nga marigrig na.
And there was pain in my soul.
Adala iti marigrig na nga sakit malipot di kararuwa ko na na.
That does not have to be there.
Nga kasapulan ko ma nga sa nga awan di jay na iti kararuwa.
But the reason why it was there because I was holding on to my burden.
No apay ka kanamin di marigrig na kura na ngamin sisak pa lang kay ngayon ko pa lang sisisak pa lang.
You know, there are many burdens that we can carry in our lives.
Amoy ka sa nakadalo iti pagkadalagsan ng mga wita iti diyan tayo.
Because there are many challenges in our lives.
Ngamin nakadalo iti pagkadalagsan ng mga wita iti tayo.
Sometimes we have financial challenges. Sometimes we are wondering, where am I going to get the money to keep paying my
bills?
You know, sometimes we worry about our future. What is going to happen when I become old? Sometimes we can worry about our children. Do we have any nana and tata here? Do you sometimes worry about your children?
Yes.
Are you concerned about, will your children be okay?
Yes.
I have two teenage children. You know, sometimes I worry about them. Because I don't know what their future will be like. But what I know is this, that I can give my burdens over to the Holy Spirit. And God will bless what you give over to Him.
Amen!
Hallelujah. And then, yesterday afternoon and this morning, as I was walking around praying, as I was walking around, sometimes praying in tongues. Sometimes praying in English. But I don't know how to pray in Ilocano. But as I was lifting up my prayers to God, as I was lifting up my burdens to God, I was asking the Holy Spirit to help me. And I could feel the burdens lifting out of my soul and going up to heaven. And I can feel the peace of the Holy Spirit coming alive within me. You know, when you feel the peace from the Holy Spirit, you know, God is taking control of your life. When you lift those burdens to God, you can expect the Holy Spirit to move into your circumstances. When you lift up those burdens to God, you can expect God will send His angels to work on your behalf.
Hallelujah.
Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20. You can read this out to them.
Efeso capítulo 3 versículo 20 con una madaydayo como ti Dios ama karami ti nasosorpay ngayon ti dawaten may nukalunotin tayo babayan ti panakabalin ng aktar trabaho kada tayo.
You know, this verse is one of my favorite verses in the Bible. God can do exceedingly above anything you ask or imagine.
Amen.
Amen. According to His power that works within us. You know, this is the story of my life. Every blessing I have in my life, it is because of the power of God.
Amen.
It is not because of me. Because I know me, I know how bad I am. I know that I'm a sinner just like every other sinner. But I know that when the power of God works through me, God can bless my life. Do you want your prayers to be answered? Over and above anything you can think and imagine. Anything you can think and imagine, God can bless you more. According to His power that works within you. I have found that one of the keys to having a blessed life is to learn to recognize the power of God in your spirit. And to learn to pray with the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And to release that power with faith. But we have a little problem. Before the power of God can be released within us, our carnal sinful soul has to be broken. Our self-reliance has to be broken. We have to stop trusting in ourselves. We have to stop trusting in anything other than God. Our self-righteousness has to be broken. You know, Jesus said in Matthew chapter 5, verse 3, blessed are the poor in spirit. So theirs is the kingdom of God. And Jesus said, blessed are the poor in spirit. Okay, Jesus did not say, blessed are the poor in money. He said, blessed are the poor in spirit. A person who is poor in spirit is a person who has had the pride broken out of their life. A person who is poor in spirit is a person who has had self-reliance broken out of their lives. A person who is poor in spirit is a person who has been placed into a position where their reliance is totally upon God.
Amen.
You know, there are many religious people. They are claiming that they are relying on God. But I ask you the question, what is the true condition of your soul?
Are
you truly relying upon God? See, yesterday afternoon and this morning, as I was walking around the Glory Farm
praying,
you know, the Holy Spirit was convicting me. He was convicting me, showing me that there were many burdens I was holding in my heart. Burdens about my children. Burdens about finances. Burdens about my future. You know, burdens about my job, my work. You know, there are many things that can cause us to feel burdens. But yesterday and this morning, as I was walking around the
bank,
the Lord was reminding me of my need to lift my burdens to Him. And to be released from the oppression that was on my soul. Only the Spirit of God can help us to be released from
our burdens.
And only what we give to God can God bless. What are we holding on to ourselves? We are keeping separate from God.
So
this morning, I want to pray for you people. I want to ask you a question. Do you want the circumstances of your life blessed by God? Do you want the anointing of the Holy Spirit to take control of your life? Do you want to know that your circumstances are being controlled by the Holy Spirit and not by you? Do you want to be delivered from demonic oppression over your circumstances? Do you want to be delivered from that curse that we hear upon? You know, there are many Filipinos who are living under Mihirapan.
Poverty, poverty.
Poverty, yes. That is a demonic curse. God wants to set you free from that. And what about your family circumstances? Do you want God to bless your children? And what about those of you who are young and single? Are you praying for your future? Do you want God to bring you the blessed one to your future? According to His power, He works within us. I give a challenge to the young people here. Would you like your future partner to be much better than anything you can ask or imagine? If you keep that burden to God,
And if you
agree with the Holy Spirit,
if
you yield to the Holy Spirit, God can bring something that is better than what you can ask or
imagine.
So this morning I want us to pray together. Because I believe many of you
here,
there is some oppression in your lives because of burdens that you have been carrying. And this morning I want to pray for you. We want to pray to break those burdens and lift them up to God.
Yesterday and
today, the Holy Spirit has been convicting me. And He's exposing the burdens that I have been carrying in my heart. And the anointing of the Holy Spirit has been helping me to lift them to God. So this morning I want to pray for you. I want to pray for the same anointing to help you to lift your burdens to
God.
And to deliver your soul from the oppression. The oppression that comes when we hang on to our own burdens. So this morning I want you to respond and let us pray for you. Since last night and this morning, there is a song that the Holy Spirit has been bringing to me. I don't know if you heard this song, but it was sung by a famous Christian singer by the name of Amy Grant. Lay down your burdens, I will carry you.
Get kunana, ngay itet mo amin nga pagkataksinam. Get adtan to maawiten ka.
Saranayin ka. I will carry you, my child.
Get kunana, saranayin ka to kasbay sa anak ko.
I don't know if you know this song, but it's a famous song.
Get kunana, jaka mo na mo yun yung kasbay sa anak ko.
I recognize the song. Lay down your burdens, I will carry you. I will carry you, my child. That song has been coming to me since last night and this morning.
And as
the Holy Spirit has been singing that song to me, I can feel the love of God touching my heart. I can feel God telling me that He will take the soul of my
burden.
When the Holy Spirit gives you faith, your soul can become full of peace. And full of faith. So I ask you this morning to respond and let us pray for you. I want you to focus your attention on God. And ask the Holy Spirit to show you. Are there burdens you have been carrying in your heart that you do not need to be carrying? And this morning I want you to bring those burdens to the altar. And we want to pray for you to help you to become released. And I'm going to believe for the Holy Spirit to take control of your life.
Hallelujah.
The Holy Spirit can only bless with you. What you give to him.
Amen. This year, the Santo, Sundarin, Jepin Tishana, Nakajimaso, Soro, Nathan Kinamudio.
So let's begin to pray.
Get a time, Gita, Goma, Karakasa. Hallelujah.
And just lift your hand to God and pray.
Get a dama, Gita, Muradi, Nimam, Get a Karaka.
Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah. Babalin, go make it someone and Kapsa.
Holy Spirit, I know there are burdens in my heart that I should not be carrying.
Kamu beri kami nama aku, Spirit Santo, bukan dari tidak sem kerjakan di puso, besar aku mengawi tawi.
And Lord, I want to repent from carrying those burdens.
Dan karena kaya kerja aku mengawi aku, di mana mengawi aku karena kita mau katak seran. Hallelujah.
Lord, I know that I have been guilty of carrying burdens.
Dan karena aku kapu, hari ini aku mas pasal tak mengawi tak kerja yang katak sem.
I have been holding issues away from you. Lord, help me to come to you with a heart of brokenness.
Aku tolongan kau mainkan kau di puso karena kesegaran anak murah.
And Lord, help me to lift up those burdens to you.
Tak semua itu kau ingin apa kata saya dan apa kata naga.
If you have burdens you want to bring to God, I ask you to come forward and let us pray for you.
Get kuran at yami si timangas ka sa pagkanka. Maasdara yun yung magatandanaga. Umayat sa wala.
You don't have to wait. You can come down now.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord.
So let's pray. Kodi masanda
Yeah.
Yes, Lord.